What up guys, my name is Jeffrey from Instant Audio, and in this video we're gonna show you the best studio monitors in 2021, ranging from $150 until $1,000 per piece. But remember, before you buy expensive studio monitors, make sure to do some acoustic optimization in your room to make sure you get the maximum out of your studio monitors that you pay a lot of money for. The second thing is that there's always a personal preference. My preference is maybe not your personal preference, so take that in mind. And of course, we cannot discuss all the studio monitors on the market. We have a selection that we really like, and we're gonna show you that right now. Let's get into it. So, studio monitors, we got a big pile of studio monitors right here, guys. We also have the Eve Audio SC307 and the Head Audio Type 7 MKH2. With these studio monitors, we got the Care Case, we got the Adam Audio T-Series, we got the Kali Audio LPs, the EN5s from Kali Audio, we got the Vocal Shape 50, we got the Monkey Bananas here, and we got the Fluid FX80, and the smallest guys in this list are the Mackie studio monitors. So let's start with the first one, which we're gonna do with the KRKs. So KRK is, I think, the most popular brand if you're talking about studio monitors, especially this type for people that are starting out. The yellow woofer, the design is super good, and it just all around it's great studio monitor. You got, with the newest generation, you got a display on the back that you can do all kind of settings with, and I think just with KRK, really decent studio monitors that can last for years. You cannot go wrong with KRKs. But next to KRKs, you got more interesting options as well. For example, the Adam Audio T-Series, and the T-Series is really developed to bring that high-end Adam Audio quality at an affordable price tag. These are the most affordable monitors Adam Audio released, and they are so well familiar with that expensive range in studio monitors. That knowledge they put in this studio monitor, and it just really translating well, especially in the mid and high end. But all in all, great monitor. It's something more unique than the KRKs, but we got something more unique above that, which are the Kali Audio EN5s. Recently released in 2021, and it's a three-way system with a coaxial design. So it's a really high-end studio monitor, more pricey than the KRKs and the Adam Audio T-Series, but the sound that comes out of this studio monitor is incredible. I think at this price tag that this studio monitor has, it's the most value for the money you're gonna get, basically. The design is not that stunning if you ask me, but that's personal taste. But sound-wise, this is an insane sounding studio monitor for the price. Let's jump on to the next one. We got the Vocal Shape 50. And if you're talking about a unique design, of course this is also in a different price range than the KRKs, but we got the tweeter here, the woofer right here, and we got two subwoofers here on the side. And these are just really strong sounding. And if you're looking for a more classical approach and vocal quality, this is a really interesting studio monitor. We still have to gonna do some deep diving tests with these, but I heard those studio monitors in other professional studios and I'm amazed. And to be honest, Vocal just makes something that's sounding completely different than all the budget studio monitors compared. Vocal Shape 50, super interesting studio monitor. Go check it out in your local music store and have a listen for yourself, because this is a really great studio monitor as well. Next in the list, let's see what we got. Yeah, I don't know what to pick. Let's go with the Kali Audio LP6. The LP6 from Kali Audio was one of the first studio monitors they released, if not the first one, correct me if I'm wrong. this studio monitor blew away the industry for entry-level studio monitors. At this price point, it's around the same than the Caracase and Atom Audio T-Series, but this quality and the sound that came out of this studio monitor blew a lot of people away. That's why loads of people replaced their budget entry studio monitors and got the LP6 from Kali Audio. Sound-wise, design-wise, it's just a super appealing studio monitor. Again, I can talk hours about the sound, but it's something you have to experience for yourself. All in all, entry level, below $200, this is something that can compete very well with Atom Audio and the KRK studio monitors. And loads of people say it sounds way better in that price range. So, super interesting monitor. Let's go to the next one. Let's start with the monkeys, And to celebrate the monkeys, I got the monkey right here that we always keep in the studio, Monkey Banana. This monkey doesn't have a banana, this one has. You can see Monkey Banana. German brand that felt that there was something missing in the entry-level studio monitor range. So they developed their own studio monitor, and I must say they accomplished very well because the design and sound is incredible. I mixed with these studio monitors for days, and just not like distorting, irritating in your ears. It's just a really good studio monitor. But you have to be in for a unique design. So as you can tell, the form of the studio monitor is unique, and the color as well. So it's a unique studio monitor that makes your studio monitor stand out compared to all the other brands. And design wise, it's super smartly done. It just, all in all, a great studio monitor. But you have to be in for something unique if you want to get this. Let's see what else we got, because the list is so long, guys. Let's go with these small Mackie studio monitors. So if you're really on a budget, you're gonna probably end up with any of these Mackie studio monitors. Super small, really desktop format. Is it professional studio monitoring? I don't think so, but it, again, if you're on a budget and if you don't want that full-size studio monitor, this is very interesting. You have one power cable, so one of them is active and this other one is passive. As you can see, passive speaker input, and you link those together and you only power this, and this one goes to your audio interface. So entry-level studio monitor, if you're really on a budget, again, this is very interesting. It still sounds decent. Again, it's not really comparable with these other studio monitors we just had, but if you're on a budget, you still get quality sound of this, and it's way better than just a general hi-fi set of speakers. Just go with the Mackie studio monitors below the €100. So those are gone. Then the last ones that are on the floor here is the Fluid Audio FX80. This is a really unique studio monitor. Fluid Audio FX80. They also have FX50, which is a smaller studio monitor. This one is bigger. And you can tell, where is the tweeter? Now, the tweeter is in the woofer, actually. So it's a coaxial design. All the frequencies that are in the high end and in the mid range for the woofer, mid low, are coming out of the same direction. So you avoid phase cancellation problems with that. It's just something that you see sometimes on more expensive studio monitors, but in this price class, it's quite unique that they managed to create this and bring this on the market for that price. It's a really well-built studio monitor. Sound is incredible. I used these for months as well. I was impressed when I've heard these. Let's check out the back of the studio monitor. Really simple setup here, TRS, XLR input, volume button, and some a dip switch for some custom settings. As well, Fluid Audio did a great job making such quality available for beginners at that price point. So that's the Fluid Audio FX80, really well recommended if you ask me. If you're looking for something more unique than the KRKs, better sound quality, go have a check yourself. And then we end up with two of my personal favorites, which is the Eve Audio SC307. Obviously, guys, this is not a budget studio monitor. So before you buy this, do the acoustic optimization in your studio, or you work with a set of Sonarworks or something. But these Eve Audio SC307 really blew my mind. I always used budget studio monitors. This was my first more expensive pair of studio monitors, and it's just such a difference in the sound. It's just incredible. On top of that, I have the Head Audio and Mark II Type 7. Really good studio monitor as well. They are closely priced compared to the Eve Audios, but the sound is as well stunning. I'm gonna do a separated video for that because there's so much to tell about them, but about those studio monitors that we're gonna dedicate a separated video to because they are worth it. This was the list of my 5 favorite studio monitors. If you have any specific questions about those studio monitors, specific features, specific comparisons between one or the other, let me know in the comments and I will answer those for you directly. To end it up with this whole list of studio monitors, you basically cannot go wrong, but it comes down to the budget you have and acoustic optimization in your room. Otherwise, it's a waste of budget. And in the end, expensive studio monitors won't make you a great producer, remember that. If you like this video, please like it, subscribe to the Inside Audio YouTube channel, and remember, always keep making music. Until next time.